installing the metal. I got this on yesterday. You're probably wondering why I didn't video it. It wasn't easy, and it took 7 hours just to get this far. Here's the deal. As you know, the S-fold, which is on the bottom here, the S-fold has to be there and stapled to the framework before you can slip another piece of metal up into it. The S-fold being stapled in is what holds everything together. You don't put staples in afterwards. You can't do it because they're under this metal. So this piece of metal goes on first, and it has to be cut correctly. So basically, what I had to do was, first I had to get the bottom piece cut. And if you've ever done this, and you've seen it in my other videos, you'll note that it's not real easy to do. To get this metal slipped down in there over this A-frame, which everything's at angles to each other, so trying to do this without bending the metal all up is a lot of fun. And you've seen it in my other videos again. So, at any rate, because they're in the other videos, I didn't really want to show this. And I'm not a fan of gravel guards, which is what this is. But the guy is going to be taking it off-road, off paved roads. And he didn't want to mess up the paint job with, you know, gravel. I told him, get mud flaps. But even with mud flaps, you can still, a stray rock or something can come up and chip the paint. So this is going to look really good. It was just difficult to do. So there's my excuse for not making video. But what we're going to do today is finish off the metal. We have to put the little metal strips in here around the windows, which I already tested the windows, put them in, made sure everything fit okay first. You want to do that before you do anything else. Now, as you've seen before, what we're going to do is draw a line all along here about 5/8 of an inch out. We'll cut it, then we can bend our metal over and staple it. Once we do that everywhere, it should be ready for J-rail. And there's no difference here than what we did in the back, so it's pretty much the same. I'll shoot a little video of it. But this is where we are, and I'm hoping that in a few days, so let's say by Tuesday by the latest, I can get this thing in for paint. So we are moving along. Okay, as you've seen, or as you see here, I've drawn a line about 5/8 of an inch out, average. And we'll cut that, and then we'll go ahead and start banging it over. Now before I can actually fold the metal over, there's something I got to take care of here. Now, this is one of the big problems that Shasta built into their trailers. And it is that they built this to leak. So there's a simple fix. I don't know why they didn't bother with it. But this is what I do. I just squirt 100% silicone rubber sealant. Now, I know I've told you don't use caulking for anything. That's to seal external leaks. That's what you don't use caulking for. For building purposes, that's what caulking's for. Building, not fixing. All right, now I decided to start on the curb side of the trailer only because I got a little extra work to do over there. And it's because, as you all know that have the Shasta window thing here, the solid side windows on these earlier model Shastas, and on the earlier model Aristocrats all the way up into the low 60s, have these same windows. You can see all these screw holes around here. I guess that's an attempt to keep the water out. And they're supposed to go all along here, but remember we replaced this piece of metal. So I've got to draw some lines for my screw holes before I can apply the goop and then put the screws in. So I'm going to do that real quick, just using a level and a pen, marking, you know, a regular ballpoint pen. Then I can put my goop in there and then put the screws in. All right, so we're just going to go around the window on the inside here and put this goop on here. The top isn't all that necessary because there's no water going to get into the top. So I'm going to go down the sides with our goop. I can get it to come out. I had this problem yesterday. I went and bought some goop and it didn't want to come out. Now I went to another store, Home Depot, bought goop, and this doesn't want to come out. I got pretty angry yesterday. There it is. Okay. Now you want to keep it away from the edge, and that's because later on, you'll see that we're going to put some rubber gasket material around. Around the window itself, the glass. And we don't want anything to be in the way of that. So just putting a bead along here. Got to get it to stick on the wood. Both sides and the bottom, and that's all you need. Now we're going to go ahead and screw the metal in. These are an average of about 1 3/4 to 1 1/2 apart, all the way up to 3 inches. They didn't really seem to do any measuring here. As you can see, that one and this one over here. This looks pretty good. Well, I gotta tell you, we've been having thunderstorms daily, and it's been so humid, it's hard to see sometimes. And right now, it's only 9 o'clock in the morning. By the time I get done here, I'll be soaking wet. I normally, of course, you saw it with the DeVille, but ran late on that one, but I normally don't plan on working outside in these conditions during the summer. This trailer just ran way over. Didn't really mean for it to do that. I gotta get this stripe away from where this screw goes, because these are glue-on stripes, sticky back stripes. They're coming off. They're coming off. This will have a painted stripe. Okay. There. This side's done. We want to make sure we got no goop sticking up down here, so we'll clean it. You know how hard goop is to get off once it
since it's there, so.
Any excess here you want to clean off? Get rid of it. You want anything holding the glass away from the metal when we get done here. Okay, so this side's ready. We'll do the other side the same way. So we'll get this side done, we'll get the strips in there, and then we can fold our metal over and the front end will be buttoned up. Oh, I'm going to be happy. All right, now when we're putting these in, of course, the top has already been stapled down on the lip there, right here and there, and then that is what holds this in. Okay, I just got done cutting this, and so now what we've got to do is, now that we have this length determined and I've tested it to make sure it's all going to fit right and everything, I can hold this here. And I'll just take this out. What we'll do, we'll insert this guy up here. Okay. Get them all straight and everything and centered. Just remember our windows cover a lot of this, so if we're a little short on width, it's okay. I don't know if you can see that, so I'm going to move the camera. Get it closer. There, you should be able to see what I'm doing now. Anyway, this thing's centered like that. We'll get a couple staples in the bottom, which is what holds everything in. Remember? Put our metal up in there, which isn't gonna be the easiest thing in the world. You gotta bend it. This is, like I say, unless you are starting from the top and working down, this can be a little difficult, and this is the problem I had with the metal down below, putting that gravel guard in. So I had to actually bend the metal out of the way, get it turned, and then slip it up inside here, see? So that's what we got to do now. And it's not the easiest thing to do because this stuff is stiff. This is stiffer, there. This is stiffer than the metal that the trailer originally came with, which was 019, 0.019 inches thick. This is 0.025, a lot thicker, so it's a little harder to work with, but in the end, it all works much better. Alright, so now we're going to go ahead and do that over here as well, and then we'll move on to the end pieces. Alright, pretty much the same thing here, except we made it a little wider because it has to fold over the side here. So I'm going to make a little bend up here on top of this thing to match this bend. Pen in my mouth. To match that bend. So I have to cut that off. Cut that.
it. Okay, my general keeper. That works. See, that's just a little too long, so cut it again. Take an eighth off. It's always better to cut things a little too big than a little too small, because you can't add to the metal. Okay, took a little more off the top. Let's say in the barber shop. Still be a little long. There we are. Kind of thought we were from looking at the other pieces. We'll take another eighth. That should work. Let's see here in a minute. Looks good. Put a clamp here to hold it. Pull that out of the way. Getting tighter and tighter because of the stuff's getting closer. We can do this. Get some more staples. Okay. Try this again. There. There we go. Okay, we'll do the other side.